So there's been a lot of false things stated about what we stand on and what we dedicated our life to and what we're committed to. So today we're just gonna shed light, you know, spread some truth, shed some light on, you know, what things really are, because we don't want people to misconstrue what this is. You know what I'm saying? So there's a lot of people on the news speaking about three gods, saying false allegations about him. And as his disciples, as his angels, as his wives, we have to shed light and speak up about, you know, the truth and what's really going on. You know what I'm saying? And for people who are real and actually have a pure heart, you'll see that a lot of the stuff that people are saying are not true. You know, people who have been watching, who follow Three God, been watching us, seeing people come here willingly, leaving willingly, and putting their personal feelings, projecting them onto our family. And yeah.
Yeah, so we want to speak the truth, because that's what we came here to do. We decided to dedicate our lives to the truth, to what is divine mathematics. We are all from different walks of life, individuals who decided to meet on one common purpose,
yeah,
to meet on one mind, on one frequency. This is who we truly are. And a lot of what was being said, it affects us in a way of, it goes against what we stand for. It goes against our morals and our principles. A lot of people have came here and said that they are agreeing with us, with the three God, with the message, with what we stand for, and then once triggered or once not getting exactly what they want, then, you know, a lot of lies get told. And we just here as understand it, like we're here to speak the truth because we understand that you know, there's nothing else to do but speak the truth. A lot of it's easy to tell lies, it's easy to, yeah, to spread false narratives, it's easy to be negative and hate, you know. So for those Michelle said, if you have a pure heart, you're going to seek understanding regardless of who it's coming from or who that person is projected to be. You know, you're going to really dig deep for the answers and the truth,
yeah,
of the matter. So, you know, we understand that, you know, there's a lot of narratives out there, but we're going to speak the truth. So,
exactly. Yes.
Yeah.
This is how rumors are started. When people speak upon things that they were not there to witness. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of people saying things that they were not there to witness. They were not there in the lives of free God. So there's a lack of understanding and a lack of understanding who he truly is in the media.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to clear that up, because this is the Messiah we're speaking about. This, yeah, is not a regular person on the street. And even if it was a regular person on the street, this is how you treat your fellow neighbor. So, yeah.
Yeah, Mama Sheba, you've been here how long?
I've been here for 4 years. I've been in Three God's Life for 4 years. So I've known him for a long time.
I've been here for 3 years, living with him every day.
Yeah, exactly.
So. Yeah, all of us have been on this journey for a very long time, walking with Three God, walking with the Messiah, walking with the Christ. And so we see him, we see his heart, we know who he is, we know his motives behind what he do. We know that he is a good person, and all he wants to do is help humanity and help his women and give them divine knowledge of self and wisdom and truth and facts and actuality. We do not live in subjectivity. Everything that Three God teaches, everything that he speaks, you can go to the internet and you can research it. It's facts. It's objectivity. It's not based in your emotions. It's not based in your own beliefs and what you believe to be. It's not based in that. It's based in truth.
Yes.
And so when people come and they get the truth, they aren't ready to hear that truth. They aren't ready to receive that truth, because it goes against the very thing that was given to them. It goes against their set beliefs that was instilled in them since they were born and little babies. So when we speak the truth, and when we give you the truth, it makes people convicted. It makes people point the finger and tell lies and tell just lies and say bad things about Three God. They put bad stigmas on him in the media. They paint him out to be this bad person, but he's really just so sweet. He's so caring. He's so loving, and he just wants his people to be upright and moral and just about what they're doing and tell the truth about what they're doing, because no one at the end of the day. You're going to be faced with, the only person you're going to be faced with is yourself. So when you just remember, when you close all those doors, when you take it down at night, you have to in yourself, you have to You have to live with that and within yourself. Yeah. You have to take it down at night for yourself. Yeah. So remember, it's not no one else you're doing anything to. It's you're doing it to yourself. You are, because at the end of the day, you are shooting your own self in the foot. Because you know the hearts of us. You know our hearts. You know who we are. You walk with us. You went deep into the jungles. You jumped in the beautiful, most beautiful rivers. You did things. He took, and three God took you places,
yeah.
and adorned you and fed you and gave you a roof and a house to live in. And he gave you so much knowledge and wisdom. He just fed you in so many ways. Mm-hmm. And when you don't get your way, you wanna bash him and you wanna take him down and you wanna destroy the very thing that we all need as melanated people.
Yeah,
exactly. We need this. This is for us. So why try to tear down your black man in the media? Because when you tear down one black man, you tear down all of them. And when one black woman is lying and deceiving her man, just know that it's not just that one black woman that's doing that. It's multiple black women that are doing that, because we represent all of humanity. We're not just one. We are not just that one drop. We are one, that whole ocean in a drop.
Yeah.
So when we jump into that ocean, we affect the whole ocean. It's a ripple effect. And so it's like a broadcast that you're sending out that sends messages to other black men to show how black women really are. Mm-hmm. And it shows that our black women are hurting.
Yes. Yes.
We are in trauma.
Yes.
We are genetically dealing with our traumas and our debilitations and our demons. And when those things are brought up to the light, it's not people don't take it well. Some people don't. Some don't take it well, and they start putting out all of these allegations and all of these stigmas and these statements and lies about three.
Right.
Because we know you, we walk with you, and we touched you.
Right.
We slept with you. We ate with you. Mm-hmm. We had real nigga moments with you. We loved you. We were kind to you. We gave you unconditional love in every moment that you were faced with yourself. We still gave you love. Mm-hmm. We still was there for you. We still and still to this day, we still gonna be riding for the three, no matter what y'all say in the media. How much y'all have information online about me? I'm still gonna ride for the three. I'm still gonna push this knowledge. I'm still gonna proclaim. I'm still gonna be here at the end of the day. So stop. I'm not going nowhere. I'm real. And you too fake.
Ooh.
I'm loyal. And I'm gonna be loyal. And I'm gonna still stand to the end. No matter what. The
rich
is not given to the swift or the strong, but those
that are the to the end.
Pyramid.
And you know what? That is true. Like, us as black women, we have a lot of trauma. And since I've been on this journey, I've realized that we have a lot of trauma when it comes to polygamy.
Yes.
And when it comes to sharing a man, we're so used to these fantasy, fairy tale, oh, I have to have my own man. And we don't even think about being in a polygamous relationship and sharing a man and uplifting him and being a virtuous woman how we're supposed to. And Velvet, this is the very thing, as many can see, that she struggled with.
Yes.
Because if three God didn't do polygamy, she would still be here and she would not be saying the things that she was saying. Mm-hmm. Everybody who has been watching knows that she did not get forced to get married.
She
if you are forced to get married, how are you forced to get married, leave, and then come back? It does not make any logical
and
sense.
Have a whole child.
She is in love. She was and she still is in love with three God, and she is upset that she cannot have him to herself.
That's the
pyramid.
That's
the motive behind everything that she's doing. It's because she can't have three God to herself.
Exactly.
So she's gonna do everything in her power to try to tear him down and tear what he's doing down, because she can't have her way with him.
Yes, I'm
Trust me, okay? No, you really don't have to trust me. But I was here the whole entire time.
Yes.
The whole entire time that Velvet was with Three God, I was here. I was here for the birth of their beautiful daughter, my princess.
Which
I
was here so happy about.
For every, exactly. I was here during the whole process. She was well taken care of in every step of the way. He loved her truly. She loved him truly. Everything was exactly like a fantasy, I could say, from what I see, you know what I'm saying? Their relationship was a fantasy for anyone, to the point where every woman that would come into, you know, around them would want the relationship that they had, because it was just so admirable and so beautiful. So what? So it's actually surprising and disturbing that you even take it this far, because you know, just the relationship that they had was so magical.
Yes.
You understand? And there was nothing, as far as allegations and the lies that are being spewed now, it's pure hurt.
Yes.
And so I actually feel sorry for her, because I know that she's going through a lot.
Yeah.
And I know that she eventually will see that she's, you know, saying things that she's saying is actually, you know, hurting her, you know, more than it's hurting anybody else.
Yeah.
But I do want to say that as a witness of their relationship and of their marriage, I was there when they got married. I was there.
She like was
I
so said, happy.
She was so happy.
Yeah.
You could look at the picture. She was so happy. There's countless lives of her, you know, even her going against her own biological family because they were, you know, not in agreement with their marriage. But you know, at the end of the day, a lot of things happen when a woman is hurt.
Yeah.
A lot of things happen when a woman can't get her way in a relationship. Mm-hmm. And I will say that the main issue was, like Michelle just said, was the fact that she didn't get him all to herself.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just sad, because he was always, number one, he was always truthful and honest with her. He never said he was going to be with only her. But, you know, people will always, they can only deal with you how they deal with themselves.
Yeah.
So, you know, I do feel bad for her. You know, I feel sorry for her. But I want to say this as somebody that, because it's just, I have to speak the truth no matter what.
Yes.
And, you know, although it's a touchy subject, being somebody that was there the whole entire time, I don't want to sit back and just see, you know, the lies being told and not say anything.
Right.
I see the lies being told. I hear them and I'm like, yo, I was there the whole time.
Yes.
I seen everything that ever happened between you. You know what I mean? We love you. We know she loves us. We know she loves Three God. And at the end of the day, what you're saying, you're going to have to answer for. Because once you lie with one thing, you're going to have to continuously lie and continuously lie. And this is what is happening. If you cannot see it with true, pure eyes.
Yes.
She just has to constantly lie to get out of that lie, to constantly build this scenario that didn't really happen.
Yeah.
There was no force of marriage or any type of force of anything.
No.
See, when you come here, you're not forced to do anything. You
know, if I tell Captain True I want to leave, I would get dropped off
he's
right
ready.
Now.
He's so happy.
We want to be here.
And, you know, everybody knows Velvet left, you know, 4 or 5.
Multiple times.
You know,
yes.
Weren't we in the show? You want to be here?
And as well as the other women that came and left. And, you know, you can come and go as much as you please.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You can still come back if you wanted to.
You can still, because that's how love is treated.
And that's why you treat him the way that you do, because you know that his door will be open for you when you
have
And the phone, when you call and you dial his number, he's gonna pick up. You know that, and that's why people treat him the way that they do, because they know that his heart is so big. But to a cost of what?
Right.
To someone destroying him and putting him in jeopardy in life? No,
right.
No. And then we have to address these things and talk about them and bring them to the light, because we don't want women to keep coming here and thinking that they can get their way, and when they don't get their way, they can go out and say all these bad things. No, we're gonna defend we're gonna defend Three. We're gonna defend what we stand for. And we're gonna set the stage for whoever wants to join that we're not gonna have this.
Right.
We're not gonna have people, if you say you're gonna join something, join it and be a part of it.
Yeah.
And when your demons and your debilitations pop up, be willing to address them and talk about them. Mm-hmm. And face yourself and not project onto anyone what you're feeling. Because remember, this is a holographic universe. You're in your mind. Mm-hmm. Beyond your five senses, there's no existence. So you are in your mind. You're experiencing your own reality. No one is outside of you. No one is external of you. You're only experiencing yourself. Remember that at the end of the day.
Period.
When you are on these, you are speaking about what you're speaking about. Just remember that you are doing it to yourself.
Yes.
That's a three.
And at the end of the day, you should ask yourself, we are on a rock in darkness. And this, with the sun that lights this reality, have you ever asked yourself, what is this?
What am I?
And I've been here for almost 4 years, and I've seen people come and go. And the common thing that these women have in common when they leave here is their inability to deal with their emotions under pressure. They're very immature.
Yeah.
And when things don't go your way, then they get very irate, they get angry, and then you will see the instability. We have so much proof. These women, they come, they have ideas. They are in love with three God. They are in deep love and admiration for three God. But when these ideas, they don't fall through, then that's when you see the immaturity come through. There's countless videos on YouTube, Instagram, that shows how they respond when they get under this type of pressure.
Yeah, right.
And then all of a sudden you see the switch an hour or two after that has passed, and then they're apologizing, saying that I'm sorry and that I want to come back. Anybody who is being held hostage would not be online saying that they apologize for the way that they behaved and that they want to come back and stay inside of their life. That just doesn't happen.
Exactly.
In reality, everyone that came into Three God's life, he was on a mountain in Costa Rica, which is so far away from the place that you grew up. You flew out there. You said, I want to join your life. I saw the teachings that you gave online, and I want to live my life by this. I want to commit myself to this. And you did not understand truly what you was getting yourself into by healing generational curses. You think you in your home in California or Atlanta or New Orleans, Velvet, you're doing the work, but in reality, you're not doing the work, because when you first set out the journey, you had your heart light. You saw all the mathematics and you said,
yes,
wait, this makes sense.
Yes.
This really does not make sense to live in this reality of the system and to give my money to the white men and my gifts and my talents to someone that is slaving me.
Mm-hmm.
And you see a man on the mountain speaking divine mathematics,
yes,
objectivity,
yes,
things that can make your life change.
Mm-hmm.
And you say, no, I'm going to go out there and go into your life. And then you get faced, because you are taking yourself into the tropics,
yes,
into his life, and you are saying, well, I'm having the same issues I had back there.
Mm-hmm.
I thought I was running away from that shit because I was going into the trees and the bees and into nature. When in reality, no, you have to come and face your shit.
Nature is your purest mirror.
Yes.
It will reflect you back to yourself. All of the things that isn't healed within yourself.
Exactly.
It's gonna, and that's what Three God is. He's a pure mirror to reflect you back to yourself. And when that is being reflected back to you, you have to accept it. And you have to, when it's brought up to you, you have to acknowledge it, and you have to, in your mind, say, okay, let me kind of consider this. Let me consider this for a moment, because this is my higher self. He is more intelligent than me. He does have the knowledge of the universe. He is.